There once was two churches. They were in fellowship with each other. They were in the same community. They were both familiar with the scriptures. In the first church, a group of members became familiar with those scriptures which exhort the body of Christ to care for the poor, particularly the hungry. They had studied that passage from Amos, where Amos rebukes Israel and says, "You sell the poor for a pair of sandals." They were familiar with the teachings of Isaiah, where Isaiah instructed Israel and said that if you truly want to hold a holy fast for me, a holy fast is one where you feed the poor, clothe the naked, watch out for the widow and the fatherless, and uphold the oppressed. This, Isaiah says, is true repentance. This, Isaiah says, is true sacrifice. These members in the first church were familiar with these passages of the scripture. They were familiar with 1 Corinthians chapter 12, which teaches that the congregation is the body of Christ. If the congregation is the body of Christ, then the congregation will do the actions of Christ upon the earth on his behalf. They will do it according to the promise that the Lord Jesus made, that you will do even greater things than these, meaning greater things than his own miracles. They were familiar that the Lord Jesus Christ on one occasion fed 5,000 men plus women and children. He fed them because they were in a remote place and it was late. They were hungry. He was concerned that if they went to the neighboring villages to buy bread, that they would faint on the way. And so Jesus fed the hungry. And this group of people in the first congregation thought to themselves that if our Lord Jesus Christ fed the hungry and we are the body of Christ upon the earth, then we shall also feed the hungry. They were familiar with the parable of our Lord Jesus Christ, where he instructs us that the Son of Man will return in his Father's glory. He will sit upon his glorious throne, and he will judge the nations. They knew that the Lord Jesus Christ said to those on his right, "Welcome you who are blessed by my Father, for I was hungry, and you fed me." And when those on his right asked the Lord Jesus Christ, "When did we ever see you hungry and feed you?" Jesus said, "Whatever you did for the least of these brothers of mine, you did it for me." Now, many members of the first congregation took these exhortations of the scriptures to heart. And they decided, we need to do something around here for the poor and the hungry in our community. And so they organized a packing event. Have you heard about these things? I have seen them on TV, where congregations and charitable organizations get together with all this food and they pack meals for the poor and the hungry in their community and in other neighboring communities. That's what this congregation decided to do, or at least the members who took an interest in it did. So they got about 20 people together for their first packing event. They packed hundreds of meals for the poor and hungry in their community. They were very pleased with how many meals they got packed. They were pleased that they had opportunity to serve the poor, and they were pleased that they had opportunity through the poor to serve their Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The members of the second congregation didn't even know the packing event took place, so they didn't go, they didn't participate, they just kept attending the divine service on Sunday morning and hearing the Word of God. When the first congregation got done with their first packing event, they had 20 volunteers and they sat around afterwards, pleased with all that they had accomplished, but they thought to themselves, you know, we could accomplish more. There are other people who could help us do this. Think if we sent invitations to the other congregations in our community. Think if we ran ads in our own bulletin and in our own newsletter, how many more volunteers from our own church we could get. And And so they went to their pastor and requested permission to do this. He, of course, granted permission. He was delighted to hear it. They ran ads for the next packing event in their bulletin and in their newsletter. They wrote letters to the other congregations in their community, inviting them to participate in the packing event. And they sent a letter to the second congregation in their community with whom they were in fellowship. When the second congregation received the invitation, they decided to send some money to support the event and to send a few volunteers. At the second packing event, the first congregation had 50 volunteers from all the churches in their community. They packed hundreds of meals for the poor and the needy. They were so pleased that they got to serve the poor and needy and through them serve their Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The second congregation had sent a few volunteers. They were pleased also. And the second congregation continued to attend the divine service and hear the word of God. The first congregation thought to themselves, think if we made a personal appeal to our church and to all of the other churches in town. I mean, we sent them a letter and we got a response. Think how much of a greater response we would receive if we personally went to their worship services and invited them. Think if one of us made an appeal to our own congregation and told them about how fulfilling these events are and invited them to come. That's much more effective than some announcement in a bulletin. And so they decided to do this. And they sent ambassadors to all the congregations in town. And at the appropriate time when announcements were made in their worship services, the ambassadors of this congregation got up and appealed that they come to their packing event. They agreed that they should hold the packing event off campus so that they wouldn't think that it was just for this church, but that it was for all the churches in the community. They made personal appeals to their own congregation, and when they held the packing event, they had 200 volunteers at the thing. They packed thousands and thousands of meals for the poor and needy. They rejoiced. Look how much the poor and needy was served. Look how much our Lord Jesus Christ was served. And when the second congregation in town received their personal invitation, they sent a few more volunteers. They sent a little more money. And they continued to attend the divine service and hear the word of God. The members of the first congregation got together after this monumental packing event and said to themselves, how can we make this better? And as usual, there was somebody out there who said, have you noticed how many other people go to church at our church and they don't participate in this? They just go to church, sit on the pew, they go home. They can do this. They can serve Jesus. They can serve the poor. Why don't they get off there? Well, then he edited that part and volunteered for this packing event. And so somebody else said, well, why don't we have our packing event immediately after church? That way, when they come to church, they'll all be there. They can just stay after and pack these things. And some other fellow said, no, that's not going to work. They'll just come to church and then they'll go home. That's not going to work at all. And then somebody said, why don't we have a packing event in place of our regular church services? I mean, after all, we're serving our Lord Jesus Christ, aren't we, by packing all of these meals for the poor? If we're serving our Lord Jesus Christ, we ought to be able to have a packing event in place of our regularly scheduled church services. And it should count as the same thing. Oh, they've never tried that before, so they discussed it among themselves. But the more they talked about it, the more they became convinced it was right. And the more they became convinced it would get those other people involved. And so they went to their pastor and they asked for permission. Now, the pastor was kind of leery about it. I don't know if I want to give permission to this. But they convinced him. They said, look, you're serving your Lord Jesus Christ, but you serve the poor. It's in the scriptures. And pastor said, yeah, I know that's in the scriptures. So it counts the same as a regular church service. In fact, pastor, it'll count more than a regular church service because we're actually doing something. And so the pastor went ahead and agreed. So, twice that year, they scheduled packing events in place of their regularly scheduled church services. Once again, all the personal ambassadors went out to all the other congregations. congregations in town and invited them to come. They thought it was a great idea. They canceled their church services on those days so that their members could participate in the packing event. But when the second congregation received their personal invitation to do this, they, who used to send a few volunteers to these things, sent no one. They gave money, but not a single one of them came. They went to their own church, attended divine service, heard the word of God. The first congregation did this for decades. 20 years they did this. Twice a year, instead of their regularly scheduled church service, they'd have a packing event to pack meals for the poor and the needy in their community and in other communities surrounding them. And year after blessed year, the other congregation, even though they were in fellowship with the first congregation, sent no one. They sent some money, but they sent no one. Everyone stayed in their own church to attend the divine service and hear the word of God. On the day of judgment, the Lord Jesus Christ sat upon the throne of his glory to judge the living and the dead. The Lord Jesus Christ raised both of these congregations from the dead. The Lord Jesus Christ welcomed both of these congregations into life everlasting. But when the first church saw that their Lord Jesus Christ was welcoming the second church into life everlasting, they complained, "Jesus, how can you let those people into life everlasting? Year after year after year, for decades, we invited them to help us help the poor and the needy, and year after year, they ignored us. They just sat in their own church." And the Lord Jesus Christ looked at the first church and said, "The second church has chosen the good portion, and it will not be taken away from them." In the name of Jesus, amen. The peace of God.